Hello, good morning, Hedgy families. Today is Tuesday, December 8th, and we are super excited to roll out our hedgehog baby boys that were born on October 12th of 2020. These guys will be available for adoption as soon as this week, Thursday of this week. They can go home to their forever families, okay? We're gonna call this group the Green Group, okay? First introducing, and he is my personal favorite, it is a split-faced little boy.
Little boy.
Now, big differences, people ask, what is the difference between boys and girls? Personality, not really anything, especially anything that I could say specifically boys do this or girls do this. Not the case. Size, absolutely. Boys are smaller than girls and they will stay smaller than girls. Boys will be about baseball size full grown, while girls, well, they get to be a little bit rounder in the curve, so they get to be about softball size. One of the reasons why this happens is that boys do reach full maturity at around 8 weeks old. So when they are about 8 weeks old, maybe even 10 weeks old, the size in which that they have grown is the size that they will be, and they are ready to make the babies. But girls, on the other hand, little girls do not reach full puberty until about 12 to 16 weeks old. So that gives them significantly more time to get, to get growing, to get those hips with those curves. In our girl video from earlier, we did post a short little clip about diets and metabolisms. And if you are more interested in that, we highly recommend you watching the girls' video.
I am my little boy.
Audie's babies are available for adoption. No one has been reserved. Their prices will be listed underneath of their pictures. And of course, like I said, I will post their pictures in the order in which I show them. So, if you're looking at the website or if you're looking at the pictures and I'm like, green boy one, this right here, he's the first one to be seen. He is green boy one. The next one will be green boy two, et cetera, et cetera. Okay.
Good boy.
He's got one pink ear, one dark ear, perfect little split face. There's his little boy part, if you can see it, just so you know that there's a boy part. He's got a spot over here, a spot over there, big old spot right on his booty right there.
He's a good little boy. He's a good boy, yes. Oh, yeah, he's a good boy. He's a good boy. He's so cute.
Okay, next one. Spent so much time on these guys. Oh my goodness. Okay, you're gonna hear bins in the background. That is because I have dogs and a cat, and they like to get all up in the hedgy business. So there are lids on the little big old buckets that I've got over here. So if you're like, what is that in the back? It's to keep the dog noses and the kittens out. Kitten, one kitten. Okay. This one is green. Green boy two. Nice dark face.
It's a good boy. It's a good boy.
Good, a traditional. No white spots anywhere, just solid, solid little colors. And like they have nose pads. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. He's a good boy. He's a good boy. Oh, you're just fine. Huh? See, look at that.
You're just throwing a temper.
You're fine.
He's a good boy. He's a good boy.
You know, everyone wants to climb into the tree, but you see, the camera is this way. Oh yeah,
I should put the camera in the tree, huh? You get some really good photo shots.
Anyways, boy two, chunky little monkey we've got here. Chunky, 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 chunky.
I know, you're so much bigger than your brothers. Okay.
Boy two. All right, and you, my friend, are gonna be boy three. I know, oh my goodness. All right. Boy three is a Sinicot. With super cute little wisp. Oh, I'm kind of a little below this camera. Sorry about that. He's got some really good little highlighted bangs right here in the front for his pintoing. And that's really all the pintoing he has. Is just, he's a good Sinicot all the way. Nice, good, you know, kind of a reddish strawberry blonde type coloring. Ah, you're pooping! Hold on, please. Hold, please.
You're on video, sir. Oh my goodness. How rude. Listen, baby wipes, guys, baby wipes. They are phenomenal. They will save you and they clean feet real quick, pick up poo-poo real quick. Phenomenal. Okay, back to business. Sorry about that. If I was a better video editor, I would have done a cut. Are you done pooing or are you still pooing, sir? At a very convenient little time. You are still, okay. Hug piece.
Let me just grab
a
paper towel. Grab a little paper towel before we step in any of that on the floor. Oh, there we go. Okay. Y'all, you know what babies do, right? They eat, they sleep, and they poo. So please excuse that in the moment of baby time. We needed a little bit of a baby break. Anyways, little boy here.
No, you don't. You get to look at the camera.
Little boy here. He is super adorable. He's got a great little personality too. He is kind of like the go-go-goer of the group, I would say. If you were going to have like a maze runner or like a, like he would be the active little dude. I mean, he'll still snuggle for sure, but I'll tell you, there are some snugglers and there are some runners. He is definitely in the runner category. He kind of wants to explore and do all the things. And
good boy.
Anyways, there's him. Blue boy. Why do I keep saying blue boy? I have no idea why I keep saying blue boy. Probably because we did blue girls. Green boy three. Okay, let's get the next one.
Oh, stinker. You little stinker. Okay.
Okay, so then this will be green boy four.
One, two, three, four, yeah, four.
Okay. Da, da, da. Green boy four is a little bit of a peanut. He's got a super dark little face with those two lines right there that run up his little forehead. Those are genetic striping. His daddy has that. We've got a spot right here, and we've got a spot right here, and then just a few little like highlights down the side. Like he's just got like just a few of these little all white wispies down his side, and then just that like super dark face. I mean, you can't go wrong. Look at that. Oh my goodness, look at that face. Oh, you're so cute. Let's get a picture in the bulbs. I'm gonna try. I could like edit my hand out. No, this way. He's like, I want to crawl in there, though. Why do you want to eat my tree? Because it smells good, mama. I want to anoint myself. That's a good boy. You can't eat the tree, though. You cannot eat the tree. That little boy. Okay. So.
Okay, boy four. Five. Oh, you're so cute.
Okay, boy five is another silicate. That really pretty strawberry blonde look. We love them. They look like little teddy bears. I know. We don't really have any white spots going on anywhere. So, you know, he's just a really good example of a pure silicate. Just, you know, that white mixed, white highlights mixed in with the... with the red.
Oh yeah, there we go. I see. Let's see if we can get you to take a picture. There we go. Good boy. Hey, good boy. Oh, you can do it. Look at David. He's so cute. He's so cute.
You guys have to know that whenever you touch the sensitive spots of them, their sensitive spots will be wherever there's fuzzy and not pokey. So like that tum-tum right here, the face, the nose, that's considered a vulnerable spot on a hedgehog. So they're going to want to protect it. And I kind of believe that you should be able to pet all of your hedgehog, okay? The best way to acclimate your hedgehog to all situations is to acclimate them to all situations. Put them in the situations, pet their face, and if he's giving a little bit of a fuss, I'm just going to keep on doing it until he relaxes and he realizes that, like, nothing's happening for you, for him to, like, be throwing a temper tantrum. You know, this is not an angry hedgehog. I feel like so many times poor hedgehogs get a bad rap that, oh, he's angry. Oh, he is, you know, aggressive. He's this, he's that. But the idea is that if you see a hedgehog like this, he's open, his quills are back. Even if he's making a, or he's like, that's him communicating with me. You know, there is a face, there is a booty. When there is no face, no booty, and his whole thing is like purely smushed in like this, and it's just all hard, spiky, hard ball, like the character off of Maleficent. There's a hedgehog fairy little dude in there. He's a good example. Or I mean, even Sonic himself, you know, when he goes into his spin, all of these quills are erupt and like sing, 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 and you don't know where their head is, where their bottom is. You don't even know where the hole is. That right there, that is an angry hedgehog, okay? That hedgehog looks significantly different than this hedgehog, okay? If he is just verbalizing, oop, I don't want you to touch my face, and he puffs at me, he's not mad, he's talking. They don't really have voices. They don't necessarily purr or bark or meow. They huff, they puff, they hiss, they growl. And sometimes huffing and puffing can be confused or mistaken as a angry type hedgehog.
Good boy. I know, sometimes they're just so misunderstood.
But if, let's say, there was a loud noise that just happened and he decided to go into a tight little ball for me and he's scared, 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 the worst thing that I could do is to take him and go put him away or bring him away from that situation. Because what you're teaching him is that when I huff, when I puff, whatever it is that I'm huffing or puffing at will then go away. And we don't want to teach our toddlers that if they throw a temper tantrum, they get their way. So let's say something loud happens or something happens and he goes into his tight little Sonic Hedgehog hard little ball and he's terrified. What I'm going to do for him is I'm going to stand there and I'm just going to hold him until he realizes that whatever the threat he perceived as is gone and that he can come out. And then the moment he comes out and his quills are back, his nose is going, that to me is showing me all the signs that he is being, that he's okay. Like the situation has passed and now I can put him away or I can bribe him or whatever have you. But whatever you do, you are not going to give in to a huffing, hissing, popcorning hedgehog. So if you want to touch his face and he's hissing at you or growling at you, I'm just gonna slowly kind of not like annoy him or being aggressive, but just very hi, honey, come on. And you're gonna just get him acclimated to it. Go slow, love, you know what I mean? Like, lead with love and just show them, like, yo, baby, nothing is scary. These guys are prey animals. So for them to survive, they have to understand and they have to have it so deeply ingrained that the whole world, they are prey. So everybody is trying to eat them one way or another, right? So they have to react kind of with those quills because they don't have a good defense. They don't have good teeth to bite or claws to scratch. They've got quills. So our job is to teach your prey animal, your prey baby, that absolutely nothing in this world is going to eat them and that they can be acclimated and accustomed and calm in any situation. And the only way to help them be calm in any situation is to put them in all situations. If you have any questions about this, please text me. Just let me know. Your hedgehog does come with a lifetime guarantee or guaranteed lifetime support line. That's me. I'm here to help you in any way I possibly can. Okay, last but not least is the very last hedgehog on our group. It is Green Boy 6. He is a great example of a reversed Pinto traditional. Okay, say hello. Hi, it's a boy. Look at the nose. When you see the nose go in, that's a good sign. Oh yeah, smell, smell, smell. So a reverse pinto is that his pinto is only on his booty and it forms a complete horseshoe all the way around. That is what makes him a reverse pinto. He has no pintoing on the line of his back. He's got a clear strip that goes right down. He does have a little bit of highlight bangs going on right here, which are just adorable. But this pinto line that is just a complete horseshoe all the way up from his arms to the other arm, that is what will make him a reverse pinto and what makes him a little bit fancy. I mean, a little bit. You are fancy. Look at how cute your face is. Oh my goodness. All right, y'all. This has been probably 20-minute video because I ramble. I apologize. If y'all have absolutely any questions, please shoot me a text message. If you would like to put down a $50 deposit and join our adoption list, we absolutely welcome you to do so. And then when you are ready to adopt or reserve a specific hedgehog, we will then collect the remainder of their invoice to reserve them for you. Unfortunately, during COVID, we are not doing face-to-face interactions, or we are keeping our personal interactions, you know, down to the very bare minimum. So we are having our families pick out their hedgehogs via pictures and a video like this. If you would like to place your deposit, have your habitat approved, and schedule your adoption, you can pay the remaining of whatever balance on adoption day, but we will not be reserving that specific hedgehog unless there is a fully paid adoption invoice, period. If you have absolutely any questions about this, please contact me. COVID has changed everything that we consider normal into something a little bit hybrid from that. So we are all trying to, figure out what the best way is for everybody and just be as flexible and as transparent as possible. All right, y'all. Well, happy hedgy pecking. We will talk very, very soon.